You can unmute yourself and speak. So translation is reposition and resizing. Okay. Translation is nothing but moving the object from one position to another position. So we will be seeing the C program to translation the object from one position to other position. So for that purpose, you require a code blocks or Turbo C also you can use, whichever software you are comfortable with, code blocks or Turbo C. Okay, so we will be using me Turbo C use karte. You can use any code blocks or Turbo C. So let me share a screen with you. So students, tumhi unmute karunas bola, okay? If you have any doubts, please unmute yourself and speak. So now mala kay karaycha hai, me program lihaycha hai mala. So for that purpose, okay, so baga, first header file I will be requiring. Upon as we are doing the coding in C programming, we know we have two coding header files, that is standard input output dot h and conio input output dot h. So first I will be writing stdio dot h. So stdio dot h means what? Standard input output. Stdio dot h, this means standard input output. We use this for printf and scanf. Then we have conio.h. So conio.h means console input output. So console input output is nothing but for a clear screen and get ch functions. And then as we are doing the graphics program, so we require a header file called as graphics.h. Okay, we require graphics.h as my header file. So now let's declare some variables globally. So to declare a variable globally, I will taking GD. So GD here stands for graphics driver. GD stands for graphics driver. So GD is equal to detect. So what this means, whatever the functions will be in the graphics driver, it will detect automatically. So int GD is equal to detect. So this will be, this function GD will be detected in the graphics.h file. So GD means graphics driver is equal to detect. So whatever the functions we will be writing, it will automatically detect the functions from graphics driver. And then we have a GM. GM means graphics mode. Okay, this is very important. GD means graphics driver and GM means graphic mode. Okay, then I will declare a variable I for looping. I want to take a loop, so I have declared I. Then N for number of sites. If I am taking line, then there will be two sides, n will be 2. If I am taking square, my n will be 4. So this is how my n works. So n is for number. Then I am taking x and y variable. So array I am taking, okay? Array I am taking array of x and array of y. So x and y point, we will be taking it into array. And then for transformation, I am taking ty and tx. Ty means translation along y-axis. Tx means translation along x-axis. So this is what I have declared. And I am declaring two functions. That is void draw to draw a object. And next function is void translate to translate the object. These two functions I have declared here. Okay. So now let's start with a main function. That is void main. And I am declaring, already declared int I for looping purpose. So here I am printing. Okay. First I want to print, enter the number of sites. Okay. First I want to print, enter the number of sites. So how many number I want, that I am writing here. So enter the number of sites. So whatever the numbers will be, I will be writing it here. So if I am taking line, then there will be n is equal to 1. N is equal to 2. If there is point, n is equal to 1. If there is line, n will be 2. If there is square, n will be 4. So that we have to give here. So number of साइट्स के एंटर द नंबर ऑफ साइट्स. आई वॉन्ट टू स्कैन दैट साइट. सो आई वी नो द साइट्स विल बी स्टोर्ड इन टू एन वेरिएबल. सो आई एम राइटिंग परसेंट डी कॉमा एड्रेस ऑफ एन. ओके, हियर आई एम टेकन द साइड. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू टेक वेन द साइट्स आर कंप्लीटेड, देन आई वॉन्ट टू टेक द कोऑर्डिनेट्स. वेयर आर द कोऑर्डिनेट्स? दैट मीन्स आई वॉन्ट टू टेक दी एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस. सो आई एम राइटिंग हियर प्रिंट एफ हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू क्लियरली? प्लीज अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड स्पीक.
यस मैम।
ओके, सो नाउ वॉट वी हैव डेड इज वी हैव टेकन दी साइड्स. ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू टेक दी कोऑर्डिनेट्स. मीन्स आई वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ अ लाइन. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू टेक दी स्टार्ट कोऑर्डिनेट एंड एंड कोऑर्डिनेट. दैट मीन्स दैट मीन्स आई वॉन्ट टू टेक दी एक्स एंड वाई कोऑर्डिनेट. सो आई इन दी प्रिंट एफ आई एम राइटिंग एंटर दी कोऑर्डिनेट्स. एंटर दी कोऑर्डिनेट्स. ओके, नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू स्कैन दैट कोऑर्डिनेट्स. बट आई नो इफ आई एम टेकिंग द लाइन देन देर विल बी टू कोऑर्डिनेट्स. दैट इज मीन्स एक्स वन वाई वन एंड एक्स टू वाई टू. इफ देर इज अ स्क्वेयर देन देर विल बी एक्स वन वाई वन, एक्स टू वाई टू, एक्स थ्री वाई थ्री एंड एक्स फोर वाई फोर. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग एवरी टाइम अगेन एंड अगेन दैट एक्स वाई कोऑर्डिनेट्स, आई विल बी टेकिंग लूप फॉर इट. सो लेट्स टेक अ लूप फॉर आई इज इक्वल टू जीरो, आई लेस देन एन एंड आई प्लस प्लस. सो इट दिस लूप्स मीन स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम जीरो टिल एन. सो वॉट एवर एन यू आर गिविंग, इट विल बी फोर, इट विल बी थ्री, इट विल बी टू. इफ इट इज अ ट्राइंगल देन एन विल बी थ्री. इफ इट इज स्क्वेयर एन विल बी फोर. सो टिल दैट वैल्यूज वी विल बी टेकिंग इन टू दी फॉर लूप. सो इन द फॉर लूप राइट हियर स्कैन एफ. ओके, स्कैन एफ परसेंट डी कॉमा एड्रेस ऑफ. नाउ सी एड्रेस ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई आई वॉन्ट, राइट? सो हियर यू हैव टू राइट एक्स ऑफ आई बिकॉज वी हैव टेकन द लूप फ्रॉम आई जीरो टू आई एन. सो एड्रेस ऑफ एक्स ऑफ आई एंड एड्रेस ऑफ वाई ऑफ आई. दिस इज हाउ यू हैव टू डिक्लेयर द एरे. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज वी हैव टू टेक अ ट्रांसलेशन पोजिशन. दैट मीन्स टी एक्स एंड टी वाई वी हैव टू टेक. सो इन द प्रिंट एफ आई एम राइटिंग एंटर द ट्रांसलेशन डिस्टेंस. एंटर द ट्रांसलेशन डिस्टेंस. सो दिस मीन्स टी एक्स एंड टी वाई आई वॉन्ट टू टेक. सो इन द स्कैन एफ आई एम टेकिंग परसेंट डी कॉमा एड्रेस ऑफ टी एक्स कॉमा एड्रेस ऑफ टी वाई. ओके, सो दिस टू टी एक्स टी वाई वी हैव स्कैन इट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज यू हैव टू डिक्लेयर द इनिशिएट द ग्राफ. मीन्स वी आर यूजिंग द ग्राफिक्स फंक्शन. सो इनिशिएट इट, इनिशियलाइज इट. सो आई एम टेकिंग इनिट ग्राफ फंक्शन. के इनिट ग्राफ फंक्शन इन ब्रैकेट एड्रेस ऑफ जी डी दैट इज मीन्स माई ग्राफिक्स ड्राइवर, देन एड्रेस ऑफ जी एम दैट इज माई ग्राफिक्स मोड कॉमा यू हैव टू गिव द पाथ वेयर यू हैव सेट द टर्बो सी. नाउ यू हैव टू चेक इन विच पाथ यू हैव सेट द टर्बो सी. सो मोस्टली इट विल बी इन द सी ड्राइवर ओनली. सो लेट्स चेक वेयर इट इज. हाउ टू चेक दैट? गो इन योर दिस पी सी इन टू लोकल डिस सी. सो सी इन द सी देर इज माई टर्बो सी प्लस प्लस, राइट? सी हियर इन द टर्बो सी देर इज माई सेटअप. सो यू हैव टू गिव अ पाथ हियर. So see, I'm giving the path here of C drive, C colon turbo C. BGI. Okay, so this is my path I have given. Now, why we have used this init graph function? method, because whatever the functions we will be writing or whatever the methods we will be using, that meaning will be already in the graphics driver, that is GD and GM. Okay, so for that purpose we require this statement. Now I will be writing clear device. So I will show you why we use this clear device function later, but it will clear out whatever you are writing. I will tell you why this clear device function is used. Now we have two functions, draw function and translate function. Draw function and translate function we have. Now when we translate the object, I want that object to show the color yellow. Okay, so I will set the color to yellow. Remember, you have to write in capital letters only. Okay, yellow color you have to write it in capital letters. So I have set the color yellow, and again I have drawn it, and then I have used the function getCH. So see what I have did. I have first draw the object, original object, then I have translated it and given the color yellow, and again I have drawn the translated object. Okay, so two time I have used the draw function. Now you have to draw the sorry de define the draw function. So I have written void draw. Okay, in the draw function I am taking the loop for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, and in that I am writing the method line. So this line method means what? Whatever you have to draw it, draw the object, that is used with the help of line function. Okay, line method. So this meaning is already stored into the graphics.h file. So here simply I am using line, then x of I, comma y of I, x of I, comma y of I. Then see, then what I am writing, x of, see this is very important, x of I plus 1, x of I plus 1 mod n, okay, comma y of I plus 1, I plus 1 mod n. Okay, so these two are very important. See, now x I and y I will be my original coordinates, and means the point where we will be starting, and the next point will be to draw the whatever you have taken. To draw this, we have considered this x I plus 1 mod n and y I plus 1 mod n. So this is the method to draw the original object. Now I want to translate the object. So for translation purpose, I am taking the another method called as void translate, which we have already declared. Here again, I am taking the for loop. For I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, and in that for loop, see what I am writing is x of I. Now I want to translate the points. So we know to translate a point, it will be my original point plus translation distance. Then only my new point will be forming. So x of I is equal to, you can write this way, x of I plus tx. Okay, x of I plus tx, or you can write like this also, plus is equal to y of I plus ty. This is also right, or the upper whatever I have written, that is also right. Okay, I have written this. This way is right, or this whatever we have written, this is also right. The meaning of this is xi plus is equal to tx means xi is equal to xi plus tx. Similarly, yi plus is equal to ty means yi is equal to yi plus ty. So this is here, this here we have end with the program. See, I will repeat it again what we have did. First we have taken a header files, hash include stdio.h, conio.h and graphics.h. Okay, then we have used declare globally gd is equal to detect comma gm. Gd means graphics driver, gm means graphics mode. So gd is equal to detect means Whatever the functions will be in the graphics driver, it will detect automatically. Then I have declared I, N, X, Y, T, Y, T, X. X and Y for original coordinates, T, Y and T, X for translation distance. Then I have taken two functions, draw and translate. Then I have started with a main function. In that, first I have printed enter number of sides. So this number of sides means if you want to draw a point, my number of side will be 1, that is n will be 1. If I want to draw a triangle, my n will be 3. If I want to draw a line, my n will be 2. If I want to draw a square, my n will be 4. Okay. Then I have taken the coordinates. So coordinates I have written it into for loop because if there is a n is equal to 4, then 4 times we have to write. So instead of that, I have taken a loop from 0 to 4. And then I have taken this function into coordinates into array x of I and y of I. Then I have taken the translation distance tx and ty. Then I have given the path of turbo C and just I have declared the functions draw and translate. And outside the program, I have written the functions draw and translate. See the draw function. Here I have drawn the original coordinates, and in the translate function, here I have translated my new points. So this is the simple program. I will save this program in C. Okay, I will give the name translation.c. I have saved this program. Now let's run this program. Okay, so see, there are some errors. We will find it out. Spelling mistake is there. Include, there should be D. Undefined symbol X. Okay, so here there is double colon, comma is written, so that's why it is given. So see, there are no errors now. Okay, I will run this. So when I will run this, see, now it is saying enter the number of sides. Now first I want to translate a line. So can anyone tell me what will be the n here? I want to translate a line. First draw the line and then translate the line. So what will be n? Please unmute yourself and speak. What will be n here? So my n will be 2, okay, as I want to draw a line, so my n will be 2. Now see, when I hit enter, now it is saying enter the coordinates. As it is a line, okay, now I want to enter my coordinates. So here I will enter the coordinates as hundred and 130 will be my starting. Then my ending will be at suppose 130, 130. Okay, 130, 130. Starting and ending points I have given of the line. Now I want to give the translation distance. So here I will give the translation distance as 20 and 30. Let's say 20 and 30. I have given the translation distance. Or you can give 20, 20. Okay. So when I hit enter, now we have used one function called as clear device. So clear device function works as it will clear the screen and print the output. For this purpose, we have used the clear device function. So see, I enter here. Just wait a minute. I will show run it again. As this Turbo C gets hang because of this graphics program, so we use the code blocks for this purpose. So better to run this programs in code blocks only. because this turbo C gets hang every time. Let's see whether it gets run or not. So let me give slides 3. Then I am giving the coordinates as 60 and 120. 120 and 192. Then I am giving 192 and 60. Then I want to give a translation distance of x and y. So here I am giving 20 and 30, let's say. See, I have drawn a triangle. Now this yellow color triangle will be my new triangle, yellow. Okay, and this white is my original triangle. So as we have given the yellow color to a triangle, so my new triangle is appeared. So this is how we have translated the original triangle to a new position. Original triangle also we have shown, and new triangle we have shown. Similar way, you can just give the number 2 and draw a line. N is equal to 2 input you have to give. If you give n is equal to 4, then there will be a square. If you give n is equal to 1, then there will be a point. Got it, everyone? Yes, students, have you got it? Students, you got this program or not? Hello, students, please respond. Have you got this or not? Okay, so this is what a translation is. Translation of line, circle, polygon, whatever you want, you can use it. Just you have to give n as different number, okay? N is equal to 1, then it will be a point. Then you have to give only one coordinate. Then if n is 2, then you have to give two coordinates. If n is 3, then you have to give three coordinates. Similarly, it will get drawn, okay? So this is a program for translation. Now we will see the program for scaling. So can anyone tell me what is scaling? Yes, students, what is scaling? So resizing of object, we call it as a scaling. So let's see a program for scaling. So let's show you, share your screen with you. Now we will be seeing the program of scaling. Scaling program is same as this program, okay? I will just copy the code. I'm just copying the same code and we will make the changes in this code, okay? So let me copy this code. Open new file and I will paste the code here. So I've pasted the code here. Now we are seeing this program for scaling. So now scaling, see, the only thing is what will be the change? Yes, students, what will be the change for scaling?